Hey guys, it's Dave Dean here. Just kind of going over my car audio install that I got done probably like a week and a half ago, I guess. I did some unboxing videos a couple weeks ago, showing you most of my stuff that was coming in here. I didn't unbox the M11 here. I was going to get the M11 Pro, but since I'm running digitally, basically just using it as a transport, into the Helix DSP Ultra in the back. So I have the coax cable that's going into that from the M11. And I also have the Amp Pro that's obviously hooked up, through the Uconnect. And that's going ToshLink, optical cable, into the Helix DSP Ultra in the back as well. So basically my front stage, and not sure if you can really see that too well right now, we got the Audio Frog speakers. So we got the Audio Frog GB10s in the sail panels. I'm gonna do a video in the morning. These things fit in there like perfectly, like it looks factory and they sound incredible. So we got the GB10s for the tweeters, and then you're not gonna be able to see these obviously because they're in behind the door, but we got the GB60s in the doors. And then next spring, I was going to do it this year, but it's kind of getting late. We'll probably end up getting snow in the next month here in Edmonton. So, probably do this next spring. I'm going to put the GB25s in the sails panels. So we'll do custom A-pillars for that. But honestly, this system is the best system I've ever heard. Like these speakers are, when I was researching these speakers on the forums, you know, last year and a year and a half ago, basically, when I used to have my old Hertz Melee setup. So I used to have all Hertz basically in my old system. So I had the Hertz, the ML1650.3s, I guess it is, for the Melees, which were great speakers. You know, I never had any issues with it. They ran perfectly for me, but I'm telling you right now, it's a night and day difference from these Audio Frogs. Like these Audio Frogs are the best speakers I've ever heard. I've had the Morel Elates before. I've had Dino Audios, not their high ends, not the SSRs, but the one, the model down from them, the GT 242s, I think they are. I've had the Focal Utopias before. I've had the KRX2s. I've had quite a few speakers over the years. These things are insane. Like the detail, like, cause you can go loud with these things and they're like crystal clear. So I'm more of like a sound quality guy now. Although that being said, I have like basically 1800 watts into my sub, so it can go loud, but I have 210s in here. Right. So, I don't go crazy with it. I like just like that perfect sound where you can turn it up pretty loud and it just sounds like great. Right. So, basically, yeah, the GB10s, the GB60s up front. Next year, we'll put the GB25s in there. And then in the back for rear fill, I'm using the GS62s, Audio Frogs as well. And then I'll show you the back. I didn't do an unboxing of these. I kind of forgot about it. But I got the Helix Q, two of them, Q10Ws in the back. And they're incredible speakers. I used to have the high energies before, the Hertz high energies, and they're an excellent sub too, in a port enclosure. But these just seem to be, give you like a little bit more deeper bass, it feels like, and it's more tighter than the high energies were. I heard the Melees too. The Melees were pretty decent in the vehicle that I heard before, the Hertz Melees, but I still prefer these Helix. I don't know what it is, but they seem to get really low. The bass notes, like I'm surprised they're 10s, because they almost, you know, they're punchy like a 10, but they get extremely low as well. I was watching PS Sounds videos back, I don't know, about a year ago, when he was doing the unboxing of, I think it was the 15, I think he was, and he was saying how good the subwoofers are. So yeah, they're pretty amazing. So I'll take you back there. You can take a look at right now. I just have an A-Trans box. It was the closest box I could find, just buying off the shelves, that would fit there right now. Eventually I'm going to go and do something custom like next year, probably when I do the A-pillars in here. I still got a sound dead in the back of my vehicle. Like the doors are all like Dynamats, fully done on the doors. But I'll kind of show you the back subwoofers here. So, those are the two 10s. And like I said, it's just in a temporary box right now. Eventually, I'm going to probably do something custom in the wheel well. I've already taken the wheel out of here. But right now, my amp rack, we'll see if you guys can see this. Might not be able to see it at night here. This thing's freaking heavy. But yeah, I got the 3 amps back there. And Visconis. So yeah, so in the back for amps, I went with the Moscone AS line. So we got the Moscone AS 100.4. so two of those channels are running the GB10s, the tweeters, and the other two channels are running my rears, the GS62s, the coaxials. And then what's running my GB60s are the AS 200.2. so I'm getting 200 watts, actually a little over 200 watts into the woofers. And then what's running my subs is I got an AS 300.2, so that gives you and that's running in 2 ohm, that gives you a little over 1800 watts into the 210s. They're rated at the Helix Q10Ws. They're rated at 750 watts RMS, like, who, you know, peak power is like 1500 watts, but obviously nobody cares about peak power, like, you know what I mean. It's all based on RMS. So I got it dialed down quite a bit. And then, of course, I would have loved to put the Helix controller, or I should say the director. I would have loved to put that down below right here. And I'm probably going to do that next year and get those the USBs and the auxiliary and everything moved out and flush it right here. But for now, we got it in here, which is not bad because I can just pop it up, right? It's pretty easy to get to it, and then I can set my volume or whatever. It's pretty cool. You guys probably seen quite a few videos on this, so you can go that's your sound setup, so whatever you want, right? It's got the voltage meter, even though in the manual it says, doesn't say it has it. It lists all the other DSPs, but doesn't list this one. But yeah, it has it. It's the same. Tells you your temperature, your voltage and whatnot, which is kind of cool. There's a lot of stuff. I'll probably just do a separate video on this. Just kind of showing you some of the features, but it's got everything you want in a controller, pretty much. It's a touch screen, so it works pretty good. If I want to change the subwoofer volume, I just hit the volume right on the subwoofer and I can go up and down on it, do whatever I want. And then, master volume. Obviously that's your master volume. So I'm trying to think of anything I missed that's on here. Like I said, I haven't did any sound deadening in the back of the vehicle yet, but I will. I got a box of sound deadening that I'm gonna do it up. I'm probably gonna do it next year though. I'm probably not gonna do it this year because I know we probably have like 1 month of like maybe decent weather here until it starts snowing again, more than likely. So I'll probably do start that next spring and just finish it off. This is kind of like stage one, and then stage two will be next spring, probably when the weather starts getting better next year. I'm telling you, I'm a kind of an audio guy, and I kind of like listening to music when it's warm out and it's nice out and stuff like that. In the winter time, I don't really care as much. Just because when it's winter out here, it sucks. It gets pretty cold out here. But anyways, back to the audio stuff. The reason I got, I think I already told you guys, the reason I got the M11 instead of the M11 Pro is basically because I can run this analog, but I'm running it digitally, right? I'm running it through a coax cable into the DSP Ultra. So I'm running it digitally, and everybody was right on the forums. When you run this thing digitally, the sound quality is, you know, significantly better than going through analog. Analog's still good. Don't get me wrong. It still sounds really good. It just sounds a little bit better and a little bit cleaner when you run the coax input. So there was no point me buying the M11 Pro because that's basically, I know it gives you a better signal through analog, cleans up the signal a lot more, apparently from all the reviews that I watched on it. But I got a 512 gigabyte card in here because I can store like, you know, thousands and thousands of songs on here. I think I got about 9,000 songs or something on here now. And then also have Tidal on here. So honestly, even through this system, it sounds incredible. But going from an iTunes song to a Tidal song, like in CD quality, you really can't hear much difference. There's a few songs that I noticed that sounded a little bit better. But it's you'd really be, you know, have a hard time distinguishing if you blindfolded somebody, put them in here. Because I thought, okay, my system sounds incredible now. I'm going to be able to hear the difference, like, easily, right? But you can on some songs, right? But that could be the recording, too. Like, you never know what the recording was compared to the iTunes one, compared to what they used on Tidal or whatnot, too, right? So, and then when you get into the high res, once again, it's very difficult to distinguish CD quality and you going up to 2496 or 24192. You know, it's got a little bit more dynamic range. Apparently it's supposed to, but it's very difficult to hear it. Anyways, I'll give you guys a little taste. What do I got? I'll just put whatever I got on here. I got the Black Eyed Peas on here. I'll just play a little bit of it on here. I know how it is. You get copyrighted anytime you play any of their music, but it is what it is. I'll put the links and stuff in the description, and obviously all the credit goes to the Black Eyed Peas, so on and so forth. So anyways, here's a little taste of it. I gotta turn down. What do I got it on? 20? That should be all right.
fire, you deal it with fuego. Can't stop, I am addicted, I never quit. Won't stop, don't need to speak to no therapist. Don't stop, keeping it moving's the narrative. I'll stop, do it like whoop, there it is.
This is a rhythm, 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 rhythm of the night.
Alright guys, so that was kind of a demonstration of my system. I know it's YouTube and you're not going to be able to hear it, you know, obviously like you could in person. I got this tuned for me, for the driver's position right now. This is my first DSP that I've ever had. The Helix DSP Ultra is incredible. It has so many features. I'm not even using half of the new features that it has right now. But I'm using the time alignment, obviously the crossovers and everything. And then everything's dialed into where I'm sitting in the driver's seat, right? But yeah, anybody, you know, I would say that the DSP is kind of the brains of your system. And obviously the Helix DSPs, you know, originally I was going to go with what is it, the 8.5, I think it's called. It's the amp slash DSP. And it sounds incredible too. Like I heard a demo with Larry down at Mobile Solutions was kind enough to give me a demo of in a Tesla down there. And that's originally what I was going to go with. And then I just kind of decided that like if something ever happens with, you know, the DSP or whatever, then you're kind of screwed, right? Not that anything's going to happen to it. Like these things are incredibly made. They're made in Germany. You know, I haven't heard anybody have any really too many issues with them or anything like that when I was doing all my research. The only reason I went with that is, like I said, if something ever happens to it, I still have my amps, right? So I'll still have music. And I don't think anything's ever going to happen to it. But if something did, then I still have my amps that I can use the crossovers on there. And I'll still have, at least I'll have music or whatever, right? So that was one of the reasons. The other reason was in my budget. Is there a higher end DSP than that? Yeah, there's the Brax you can go into, and that's crazy amounts of money, right? So it's about $2,000 for the Helix DSP Ultra, but you're looking at, I forget how much it is now. It's like $5,000 or $6,000. You can get custom features done to it, but, pretty much 90% what I was explained to when I was at Mobile, I was like 90% of the, you know, in the Brax DSP is in the Helix DSP Ultra, right? For the most part. And it all uses the same software anyways, right? What I noticed with the DSPs, when you're starting with like the DSP Mini and you're going up to say like the 0.3 or the DSP Pro Mach 2, and then you get into the Ultra, your signal to noise ratio goes up a little bit on each model, right? So for me, I'm always looking for the highest signal to noise ratio. I know that's not the end all be all when it comes to car audio, but anything I've ever bought in the past, coming from like I'm an old school guy, right? I grew up in the 80s for the most part, the 80s and 90s when car audio was like, you know, it was at its top, it was at its peak back then. And I always looked for whatever, like in a DAC back then, back when they had single DENs, I was always looking for whatever had the highest signal to noise ratio. And I was never disappointed, right? So it was the same kind of thing. Even this M11, right? If I'm going to go analog through here, it still sounds like incredible in here, because that has, I think it's about 116, I think is the signal to noise ratio on that. And then on the DSP Ultra, it's 117. If you go digitally, and then analog is 111. So yeah, I'm blown away, right? Like I got all this stuff all at once. So, you know, if it's the DSP making it sound good, or if it's the AudioFrog speakers that are making it sound good, I think it's like a little bit of everything, right? Like I said, my last system, which is, that's the only thing I have, you know, it was in a totally different car, but that's the only thing I have to compare it to, other than I've heard a lot of people's vehicles, right? And I've heard lots of different speakers and different combinations and other DSPs. I never heard a DSP Ultra, but I heard the Mach 2 before, and I've heard the Mini before in other vehicles. And, you know, I've heard the Hertz DSP, and I've heard the Audison's DSPs, and I've heard the Moscone's DSPs, so on and so forth. This, I'll compare it to my old system. It was a good, decent system for what it was. Obviously, I spent more money on this system than I did on my old system. And like I said, my old system was like pretty much all Mele, all top of the line Mele components in there. The 1650.3 is great. I love the tweeter. Probably was my one of my favorite tweeters was the ML280.3. But that being said, I think the Audio Frogs still blow it away. Like, I think it's kind of almost a night and day difference. Mind you, I had passive crossovers on those before. So if I hook that up, say at the same DSP, you can kind of adjust it to how you want, right? So they were good speakers. I just think these are better myself personally. Like the GB60s are just like mid-bass wise. Like I don't think you can beat it out there. I don't think there's anything, you know, the old JLZR 600s used to be pretty good. Back in its time, the Dyno Audio SLTARs are really good, the 650s. But I think the Audio Frogs, like, if you get a chance, check them out. I got nothing but great things to say about them. These things are friggin' awesome. I can turn my subwoofers off, and the mid bass in here is just crazy. Fills up the cabin. Like, I would be happy, put it this way, I'd be happy even if I didn't have subwoofers playing with these things. Once you get to a certain volume, like I played it pretty low right there. I have it on 20, right? If I want to listen to it pretty loud, from 20 to 10 is a huge difference on here for my system. So if I want to go really, really loud, where like I could walk, you know, I could walk from here to like almost like Walmart over here, and you could still hear the system like clear as day from over there. If I had it up at about 10, I'd say between 8 and 10, right? That's probably as high as I would ever go on the system. But yeah, check them out. I know they're hard to come by. I had to special order mine, through one of the stereo places in town here. Because I think the closest place to me was in, like, I'm in Alberta, the closest place that actually stocked them was in BC. So I had to special order mine, and they came out of Ontario. So I know not a lot of dealers carry them, but if you can, check them out. Maybe, obviously this year is pretty bad because of COVID, so you can't go to any kind of, like, you know, any shows or car shows or anything where you might be able to hear them. But, definitely, yeah, go ask your shop if they've heard of them, or if they can get them in, or whatever, or just try to find somebody that has them and listen to them, because I can tell you right now, you're not going to be disappointed. I'll never change the system ever. I'll probably put the mids in there and the A pillars next year, and that'll be it. I don't think I'll ever change anything. I'm probably gonna do a little bit of custom stuff in the back, because obviously I'm not going to keep those subwoofers in there. I want my trunk space, so I'm going to probably put the trunk or the subs in the wheel well, and then we'll do something with the amps, somewhere from where they're at right now. But other than that, yeah, I'll probably do a few other videos with some other songs and stuff on here. Like I said, it's hard to, like, I go and watch all the audio guys on there. PS Sound, Dean, Five Star Car Audio, Matt Schaefer's videos, you name it. I pretty much try to follow everybody, try to get as much information as I can, before, when I was, putting together this system. I'll probably do a few more videos with some things. I like listening to them on other people's, videos. So I know, obviously it's not going to sound the same as you actually listening to them in person, but, I always find them kind of cool anyways, cause you get a little bit of like a little snippet of, you know, the car audio, stuff when somebody plays it. I always get disappointed where somebody shows you their system and they don't play any of the music or anything. But I understand why they don't, because it's, you know, it's a copyright video and they're trying to grow their channels and whatnot. You know, but it, what's the fun in that? Everybody wants to like hear it, even though it's, like I said, it's not going to sound the same, obviously, if you're sitting in the driver's seat and you're actually there, then you'll actually get to hear what it really sounds like. But I can tell you right now, best system I've ever had in my life. Sounds incredible. Best system that I've heard personally. You know, obviously it's me, so I'm a little biased, but, I could probably tinker around a little bit with the tweeters. There's a couple of frequencies there, even though it's been tuned, but I think I got to go in there and check out the tweeters a little bit, because there's a couple songs that play, they play like pretty much the whole entire song perfectly, but there's a couple of notes when it hits it. It's a little bit, sounds like a little bit distorted a little bit, you know what I mean? So it's the frequency kind of thing. So, you can always go in there and fine tune things, and you're not going to have every song play perfectly. But I'm gonna tell you right now, like some of the old music that I used to listen to on my old system from a couple of years ago, when I heard my Hertz Melee, it's like those are pretty clean speakers too, for the most part. Some of those they played some of the old music, like the 70s and stuff like that, and the 80s, pretty decently. But when I sat in here and I started going through my playlist and stuff, I was like blown away. Because now, obviously I got more power in the system too, but now those old 80s songs and 70s songs and stuff like that, I can crank them up and they're crystal clear now. Like, you know what I mean? It was kind of what I was missing before. But like I said, I added a lot more power in the system too. So it's hard to compare. Unless, the only way you can really compare speakers, like, is if you take your exact same vehicle and you do a speaker like swap out, right? And then you do your gains and everything, and then you EQ it with your DSP. But that's very difficult, because how are you going to do it, right? It's like, because the speakers, you might have to tilt them a little bit, you know, a different way than what these are. So anyways, I don't know, I'm kind of going off track here, but it just, whatever you buy, just be happy with it too. This was my budget. It was a fairly big budget for this. I had one of the amps already, so that wasn't bad. And I had some of the other speakers, or I didn't have the speakers. Everything else was like brand new, but I did have one amp, basically. I had an AS200.2 that I had already, and then everything else is like brand new. And that's it. That's pretty much it. Stay tuned. I'm gonna try to put some more videos up, and I'll do one obviously in the daylight, because you can't really see anything in here. And that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.